Dear beautiful crystal lovers, welcome back to the channel, and if you're new here, let me introduce myself. My name is AM and I'm the founder of Aviuvi. I've done a lot of recalibrating in the last year, and my everyday life experience is now quite different, and I'm happy to say even better than before. And I see it all around me too. People taking time to prioritize the things in life that are meaningful to them, spending time with the people they love, enjoying nature, eating healthy, creating new projects, beautifying their homes, relaxing, having fun, and being kind to one another. I don't know about you, but what I'm seeing with my own two eyes is a very different story than the one that I see in the media. But I'll get back to that later. Like many of you, this time has inspired me to learn skills that I've always wanted to learn, but never took the time to explore. For me, it has mainly been around self-sufficiency and how it can provide me and my family with nutritious, organic, and delicious food. I've used this time to get smarter on permaculture, polyculture, and biodiversities, amongst other things. And now my family and I can enjoy fresh, homegrown crops all summer long. For me, the theme of this time has been breaking even more free from some of the systems that we are all conditioned to follow in order to fit into the matrix of modern society. Another change that I've made is to spend even more time in nature. I was always a barefoot, tree-hugging fan, but I am so happy to now consciously make an effort to primarily spend my time with my hands in the soil or playing in the woods and breathing in fresh ocean air. Thirdly, I pretty quickly decided to furthermore cut off from conventional media, to keep off of social media, and only expose myself to sources of information that I trust. I am pro-love, pro-peace, pro-freedom, no matter what the circumstances are. I believe that the contrasts that we are experiencing now, on a collective level, are just the beginning, and how we individually choose to expand or contract is entirely up to us. Like so many others, I knew that this time was coming. So I started working professionally with crystals and I became a QHHT practitioner so that I can be of assistance to you during these extraordinary times. Today I'm giving you 7 tips on how to thrive right now, and I deeply hope they will be helpful to you. Personally, my wish for us human beings is that all the shadows, all the secrets, all the manipulation will be brought into the light and now, once and for all, be transcended. For that to happen, everything must be out for everyone to see. And what we have experienced so far, I believe, is just the tip of the iceberg. Waking up means realizing how much you unconsciously and by default are contributing to keeping yourself and others in unhealthy systems. The media, the medical industry, the banks, the school system, how we treat the planet and all of its inhabitants, the products we buy, and who we give our power to are just a few of the topics I believe and hope will be at the forefront of the global conversation. So how are we going to transcend and transmute everything that is coming our way? Here are 7 ways I thrive during a challenge. Number 1 is to trust yourself. A movement, a politician, a particular news outlet, authorities, a spiritual leader, family, friends, all have their own conscious or subconscious agenda, and so do you and I. I find that helpful to keep in mind when I'm listening to outside sources. On one level, we are all biased due to our limited experiences. However, on another level, we all have free access to the unlimited wisdom of life. In these challenging times, it's crucial for me to first and foremost listen to my own intuition, to establish a direct connection between me and my highest self, and to practice self-mastery. It takes time to unlearn dependency on others to tell you who you are and what to do, especially when you're going through a challenge. So having crystals around to remind you of your own divine power is very helpful. For example, every time you want to check the latest news or social media, treat yourself by picking up your favorite crystal, taking a deep breath, and turning your attention inwards. Number two is withdraw. Instead of fighting the systems, I withdraw from the systems. It's impossible to trust or make sense of everything that the conventional media is feeding us. So when I feel the need from time to time to disconnect with quote-unquote what is going on in the world, I do that. If I'm directly or indirectly fighting what is, I know that this is the least constructive way of dealing with a challenge. I know for myself that when I'm angry or fearful, my judgment is compromised, and I end up breathing even more life into the problem than necessary. That old saying, where attention goes, energy flows, rings true for me. And I remind myself that it's always my individual choice whether I want to engage or not. It's so easy to get carried away. So if I want to take action, I wait until I have the appropriate mindset to do so. Number three is to get spiritual. There's an abundance of amazing alternative healers available to assist us throughout this time, and I'm so grateful for all the help that I have received throughout the years. For many, QHST is the way to go, and it definitely was for me, but generally go for whatever feels interesting. Books, podcasts, YouTube channels, Instagrammers. There's so much free, high-quality wisdom provided just to help you out right now. So tap in and enjoy. In times when I prefer doing it on my own, I find that crystals are a great help. In this last year, I've been working with herkimer diamonds, of course, but also hematite, that has really helped me ground and stay focused in the present moment. As always, I encourage you to work with any crystal that you feel naturally drawn to. Number four is big picture. I find that whenever I have a challenge, it's helpful to observe it from a meta perspective. For example, in the time span of my life or in the time span of history. When I observe challenges from a broader view, they become more manageable and the solutions get clearer. Number five is to stay in the now. For many of us, memories from the past or projections into the future are often the cause of suffering. And that is very much what I see playing out in the world. The truth is, of course, that neither of them exist, and there's only the present moment that is real. I used to be a planner, but lately, I've tried just to plan a couple of months ahead. I find that it's impossible to predict what lies ahead. The times are definitely calling us to stay in the present moment. Number six is unity consciousness. Unity consciousness means service to all, including yourself. In my life, I've learned to respect that there is a time for company and service to others, like when I'm writing or making videos and having QHHT sessions. And then there's a time for solitude and service to self. That's not how it is for everybody, but that's how it is for me. I honor my time alone because it provides me with the mental surplus to notice the causality of life and take the time to integrate what I'm learning. I find that maintaining my own energetic hygiene is not only serving me, but everyone around me. Number 7 is to be idealistic. It's very easy to get carried away with the drama, but don't let it distract you from your true purpose, promoting what you love and creating solutions. Manifesting our individual visions of paradise is what we came here to do. So be the change that you want to see. My paradise is love and freedom, abundance, creativity, deep connections, and expanding my mind. And I refuse to accept that anything less is okay for me or for anyone else who wants it. Maybe your paradise is different from mine, and that's great. That's the beauty of diversity. We need all the wonderful visions to come alive, and perhaps someone else will enjoy your vision just as much as you do. These are just 7 tips that have helped me get back into my alignment when I lose balance. For most of us, if not all, life is continuously challenging, a steady stream of opportunities to grow and evolve. Collectively, we have bought into the delusion that we will gain wisdom through ignorance, peace through war, and freedom through slavery. For so long, we've been giving away our individual and collective power. So I'm very optimistic that this seems to be the time when we take it all back. I'm not saying that it's going to be easy. And I want to mention again that this is just the beginning. What is going to bubble up to the surface, only time will tell, and undoubtedly we will be triggered in ways that forces us to take a deep look at our own shadow sides. That is it for now. I hope you feel inspired and empowered. Please let me know if I can assist you in any way in regards to crystals, or if you have any questions or comments. And if you would like to know more about QHHT and past life regression. Thank you so much for listening. And if you enjoyed this podcast and would like more of this type of information, make sure to like, share, and subscribe. It helps to get the message out to those who are looking for it, and it helps me to know what you want me to talk about. Have a great day with lots and lots of love to you and yours.